All right, what is going on YouTube? Today we are going to be looking at Eugen Sandow, the original fake natural. Or was he? And before we get too far into this video, let's get a little bit of a background on who Eugen Sandow actually was. Frederick Mueller, better known as Eugen Sandow, was born April 2nd, 1867. Best known for his stunts and theatrics when it came to strongman-like theatrics, like lifting people up or breaking chains and bands and all of that stuff. He was also known as a robust, you know, masculine presence in this time and in this era. Unfortunately, in 1925, Eugen Sandow ended up passing away from a brain hemorrhage, which was believed to be caused whenever his car was stuck in a ditch and he tried to essentially lift the car out of the ditch. And it wasn't like he passed away right away. It took a couple of years after straining himself when he tried to lift his car out of the ditch, and that ultimately led to his demise. And so with that said, let's get into some of the physique photos that are around, kind of highlighting Eugen Sandow's physique. We can look here on Google and see that he was pretty jacked. He was very shredded, very lean, had apparently a lot of muscle mass, very strong aesthetic. And you look at this and it's almost hard to believe that this guy wasn't taking some form of PED. You can even see in these photos, he has very good striations. His shoulders are, you know, clearly bouldered up. He's got, you know, a killer six pack and looks amazing. And it's hard to believe, like I said, that he wasn't taking any kind of PED whenever you look at these photos. He essentially looks like a Greek god. But as always, it's not always as simple as, you know, looking and seeing the physique or the muscle bellies that one person has developed on their own by hard work, whether or not that means you're taking PEDs or not. If you look at Eugen Sandow, as I mentioned, he passed away in 1925. And this is key, because if you look at NIH, they'll actually, you know, openly say that when it comes to the first known use of PEDs, we're talking about 1935 in Germany. So how does Eugen Sandow use PEDs if they weren't actually created and testosterone wasn't actually synthesized until 1935? And of course, it's as simple as he wasn't on PEDs. But of course, I'm making this video for a reason, and what's my purpose here? Well, in my last video, I discussed Jesse James West, why I didn't think he was on PEDs, kind of called out another YouTuber, mentioned the fact that I thought that the guy didn't do his job, or at least do his research when it came to the video that he made. And one thing I was thinking about afterwards, you know, trying to make these videos, trying to make sure that I'm making content for people to, you know, reach for the sky when it comes to their physical limitations and when it comes to achieving their goals. And what I was thinking about was kind of how there were people prior to, you know, normalized PED abuse that were able to build these very aesthetic, you know, Greek god type physiques. And one person that stood out to me after doing a little bit of research was Eugen Sandow. Because it would have been impossible for Eugen Sandow to build a physique that looks like that, it kind of got me thinking, like, you know, if it wasn't for the internet era, would it really matter if someone was a fake natural or not? And the answer still might be yes, but it also might not be. Because at the end of the day, when it comes to your fitness goals and what you're trying to strive for, what you should primarily focus on is what you're capable of doing. And while admittedly, I love watching Natty or Not videos to kind of, you know, help myself learn more about PEDs and things like that, and it's an easy source, right? Watching a video is always going to be very simple. It's a humble reminder to kind of step away from that from time to time and really just focus on yourself and your fitness goals. And while all that's fun and well, I think the problem with these Natty or Not videos is this, right? If you have a reason not to strive and put your best foot forward, you're not going to. And when you look at these Natty or Not videos and everyone's so obsessed with, you know, calling out these influencers and saying that they're not natural, and that's great, but at the end of the day, it kind of also enables your progress. I'm not saying that you're going to look as good as, you know, a Jesse James West or, you know, Alex Eubanks when it comes to, you know, just naturally working out and eating the right way and sleeping well and focusing on your recovery and all the things that it takes to be, you know, super aesthetic and look great. But at the same time, I do think that you're taken away from your own physique whenever you're focused in on whether or not somebody's natural or not. And while it's fun to sit here and watch these natural or not videos, don't let that hamper, you know, your own progress. Put your fucking best foot forward, grind as hard as you can, and try to work out and have the best physique that you can possibly have. And if you're not even interested in that, you know, you're trying to hit new PRs, focus on that. You're trying to just be healthy, focus on that. There's a lot of like misconceptions when it comes to this whole entire fitness industry, and it gets frustrating to watch people complain about how they can't take that next step forward or it takes too long. When it comes to fitness, this is a marathon, not a sprint. So like I said, put your best foot forward and stop allowing these petty little, you know, Instagram influencers or whoever the fuck you're watching take over your, you know, vision of what you can possibly be. If they're on steroids, that's none of your business. Look the other way and just focus on yourself. I'm not saying that those people don't deserve to be called out, but if you're gonna call them out, A, do your homework, and B, you know, keep in mind that the best thing for you to do is to focus on what motivates you. You might be following somebody who's a fake natural, and there's people in the industry who have been fake naturals and have come out and been clean about it and ended up, you know, building a good career for themselves because at the end of the day, they were able to motivate the people that were watching those videos. And the point of this video, again, is not to sit here and give some type of excuse or some type of pass for somebody who may or may not be on PEDs. Instead, it's an excuse, or it's a video that I wanted to make because, like I said, I want to make sure that the people watching these videos get to take the right steps forward. And trying to sit here and watch all of this content, such an overload of bullshit that, you know, like, even sometimes whenever I'm watching it or I'm scrolling to my Instagram feed or whatever, it's like, I don't have the same physique as these people, but that doesn't mean that, you know, just because I haven't reached that mecca yet, that I never will, or maybe I won't. I mean, I'm not genetically gifted. There's nothing significantly great about me, but at the end of the day, I'm not gonna allow my own excuses or the fact that I'm not on PEDs to hamper my own progress. Instead, I'm just gonna focus on myself, try to get 1% better, and eventually, you know, that time will add up. And if you yourself are, you know, struggling to find a place when it comes to your fitness journey, my suggestion would be to make a bunch of micro goals that you can set every single day, like simply going to the gym, getting in cardio X number of days a week, you know, lifting heavy or setting a realistic PR for you to hit in the next year. And just allow those little micro goals to go ahead and climb up the ladder to obtain the physique or the strength PR that you're looking to obtain. And I mentioned before that there are different people who have come out and they've been fake naturals before. And, you know, they've still managed to pave out a very good career for themselves because, again, you're looking for people that are going to motivate you in this industry, not people that kind of give you the fallback of saying, well, I can't do it because I'm not on PEDs. And I do have a good example of somebody like this in the fitness industry. I'll be sure to post an entire video about them next week on Monday at 5 p.m. Mountain Standard Time. So be sure to keep an eye out for that. And if you're looking for somebody in the fitness industry who is going to be able to, you know, help motivate you, don't focus on whether or not they're natural or not. And don't assume that you can hit their peak physique just because you're watching their videos, buying their bullshit programs, or following their bullshit diets. Instead, use them as a source of motivation to help fuel your workouts, but don't get so attached to these influencers who are sitting here trying to feed you all of these different things to do. Try to use their content as a way for you to take a step in the right direction, but don't be bedridden on one particular influencer. There's so much media and so much influence and so much, you know, information floating around that it's important to have a couple of different go-to people that can help motivate you, but their word is not necessarily their bond. And it doesn't necessarily mean that they're going to be, you know, the best source for you to go to take that extra step further.